and a special welcoming sign cooked up by the Hoosier gang. Here was Blind Blake, the most famous calypso player of them all, who rode his rhythmic way all over the wrong syllables. Boy, this was a fiesta. Hiya, Maury. Having a hot time? Great trip, isn't it? With that West Indian sun pouring down on us, there was just one remedy, and a trip to the coral and straw market was it. There we could buy coral and shell jewelry for our ladies, or straw hats for our balding dolls. Even with the exotic camouflage, we could recognize Walt Siebert, Art Wickstrom, and Jack McDonough. You know, those weird hats aren't made to be worn indoors. The island was all ours to do as we please, shopping, swimming, or sightseeing. Some of us visited old Fort Charlotte, built in early days to drive away marauding buccaneers. But that didn't keep us away. There's the government administration building on Mount Fitzwilliam, a public building with the most beautiful grounds you've ever seen. To my way of thinking, there was no place lovelier or more exclusive or more downright ritzy than the Montague Beach Hotel. What a playground. And man, what a place to eat. And what a lunch. You couldn't eat as well or as comfortably anywhere.